sisters tonight, and we are so thankful to God for each and every one of you who've taken the time to tune in to this hour. I would like to welcome those of you that are viewing by way of TV 62 as well as Facebook, and to our family on YouTube. God bless each and every one of you. I would like to ask, before we go any further, if you would be so gracious and so kind as to take a quick moment and text a friend, post a friend, and tell them, turn on TV 62. The Ray Sisters are here to pray for the people of God. We're here to stand in the gap, to make up the hedge, and to intercede. I'd like to take a quick moment and give God glory for Pastor James T. Meeks. Amen. The pastor of the Salem Baptist Church. Amen. The House of Hope. We do honor God for his allowing us and giving us this opportunity to take this time to call on the name of Jesus. Jesus, our Savior, our King. I'm so glad tonight to have this opportunity to pray for you. So just before we begin, amen, tonight again, I just want to give you a moment. Call someone and tell them you must turn on Faith in Crisis tonight, because we have discovered that the power of prayer is real. Praise God. Grace and peace be unto you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. At this time, we're going to hear just a little bit from our baby sister, Tanya, as she shares a bit of this song. Amen. Because God is the greatest power. We shall never be defeated.
Hallelujah. Do you believe it tonight? Those of you that are watching, we love you in Jesus' name. Because God is the greatest power, we shall never, never be defeated. I came to tell you, because our God is the greatest power, shall never, never be defeated. Believe it tonight, because God, he is the greatest power. We will never, never be defeated, because my God, Jehovah God, he's the greatest.
Greatest power. My God, we shall never be defeated in the midst of emergency, in the midst of crisis, in the midst of a global pandemic. We still believe in the power of God. We believe in the power of prayer. We believe that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Our God has proven himself before, and he shall prove himself again. Hallelujah. We're so glad to be together. We've not been together in some time, praise the Lord, to just sit and talk about the things of God. And we just want to take a minute. Let me first introduce to those of you that may not know, maybe if you're viewing for the first time, we are the Ray Sisters. Amen. Natural sisters, 2 years apart born. Amen. And I want to just take a moment and thank God for the firstborn of the family. She is our church administrator, and God uses her in the business aspect of our ministry. And we're just so thankful to God for the gift that God has given unto her. And I'm just going to introduce at this time our eldest sister. Her name is Evangelist Cheryl Ray.
God bless you. Thank the Lord. I am so elated motivated to be here. I want to thank God for Pastor Meeks in his absence. Yes. Praise the Lord. Amen. But I want to thank God for this opportunity to speak to the Chicagoland area. We are products of Chicago. We were raised on the south side of Chicago. And I would just like to ask if you would do me a personal favor. Won't you get your families and surround the televisions? We're going to talk for a few moments, but we're going to pray in a little bit. And I would ask that you would, husbands, get your wives. Wives, get your husbands. Get the children and gather in and let's have family prayer tonight. For those of the singles, those of you that are, well, I'm not married, I'm at home by myself. You're not by yourself. The Lord is there. But draw close to the television or the computer and let's have a word of prayer. We're going to corporately go before the throne of grace tonight. I want you all to ever be so encouraged to know that Jesus is standing with us. We're not alone and we still have the victory. What y'all got to say tonight?
Praise the Lord. We do have the victory. Greater is he that is in you, in us, than he that is in the world. We appreciate our eldest sister and we thank God for her tonight. And the second born of the family, she is a trailblazer, a fire, I'll call her fiery, anointed woman of God who is a prayer warrior indeed. But she also serves alongside as our assistant pastor for Angie Ray Ministries. I would like to introduce and let you hear from our second sister. Amen. Pastor J. Denise Ray.
Praise the Lord, everybody. God bless each of you that are tuning in on tonight and those that will look and see this broadcast a little later. I just love you all with the love of the Lord Jesus. And we came to the Chicagoland area tonight to let you know that God still loves you. He still cares. He still sees. And he's right here. We love you guys. And I'm telling you, if you're watching, share with someone. And like my sister Cheryl said, get your family. Call a friend. Call a neighbor. Anybody that you know that need a breakthrough on tonight, I guarantee you, if you just tell them to come on and believe God with us, that the Lord will answer. And guess what? He'll answer by fire. He's a wonderful God. I want you to know that. And I am so honored to be a part of these wonderful ladies, the Ray sisters. And like Cheryl said, we came from the south side of Chicago. I went to South Shore High School, Horace Mann Elementary School, South Side. Amen. So I'm just grateful. Thank God for Pastor Meeks and this wonderful church. We just love God. Amen. And we appreciate each and every one of you in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. The Bible says in Acts 6:4 that we will give ourselves to prayer and to the ministry of the word. Our passion is prayer. Amen. God has caused us to be born from a woman of God who has gone on to glory, but she taught us the words of prayer, the late Dr. Angie Ray. Yes. Amen. And we just appreciate our late mother. And I was just thinking about how God allowed us to be birthed from, you know, the threads and the fibers and the cords of prayer that make up a fabric, amen, that God allowed Dr. Angie Ray to invest into our lives. She taught us how to call on Jesus. In fact, I'm reminded of moments when we were little girls and we would come and gather around. Mom would say, come on, girls, gather around. We're getting ready to pray. And I tell you, Mom would teach us how to pray. And she would tell us, listen, when you pray, be real with God. Yeah. Don't play with them. Amen. Yeah. Amen. She taught us how to call him from our bellies. That's what she said. Yeah. And she would tell us, listen, this is no time to be cute now. Yeah. You got to call him like it's your last time. Yeah. But I thank God for our late mother and how she took time and taught us the words of prayer. But at this time, I want to introduce to you our baby sister. She is an evangelist, but she's also a psalmist. Yeah. Amen. And God has gifted her to shift atmospheres. I've seen it for myself, how God anoints her to go into a room, a church, a stadium, wherever, and sing until the glory of God begins to fall. I thank God for the weight of the anointing that rests upon our baby sister. We want to welcome Tanya Ray at this time.
Praise the Lord. God bless you, Pastor. God bless everyone that's viewing this telecast. Those of you that are on Facebook and social media, we want you to know that we love you with the love of Christ. Want to encourage you to know that Faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. So if your faith has been tried during this time with the coronavirus and COVID-19, you may have lost a loved one, and you're going through in your heart, in your soul, in your mind. We're here tonight to stand in the gap, to make up the hedge and pray for you that God would meet every one of your needs, answer your right desires, that he would strengthen your faith on tonight. We want your faith to be increased and to know that God is who he say that he is. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never be defeated. I lost one of my friends on this past week, and somebody said, well, how can you guys still rejoice and still praise God in the midst of sorrow and knowing that you've lost a loved one, somebody that you love and care for? And I told them, because we're still not defeated, because blessed are they that die in the Lord. We can rejoice when a soul has gone to heaven and seeing the Lord face to face. And so we give God the glory that no matter what you're going through, no matter what you're facing, God is with you. He cares about you. He sees, he knows, and he cares. And we're going to pray for you tonight. If you have prayer requests, you can call the prayer line, send an email, send a Facebook message, and just say, pray for this, pray for that, and we will stand in the gap on your behalf in the name that's above every name, and that is the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. I want to say to the city of Chicago that we love so very much, we recognize that our African-American community and minorities have been disproportionately affected by this coronavirus. So many have passed away because of underlying conditions of heart disease and diabetes. Right. And so many don't have doctors. You know, we often hear people say, call your primary doctor if you want to get a test. Well, there are some people that can't afford insurance. You all know what I'm saying? They can't afford being able to just call their primary doctor. So oftentimes, they sit at home and suffer, just suffer through the process of even suffering with this virus. But tonight, we want to pray. We want to pray for our people. Amen. We want to pray for minorities that have been in communities where, you know, sometimes some areas, they have been so impoverished that they don't have grocery stores that have vegetables and fresh fruit because of a food desert, many of whom have become just addicted to fast food. Y'all know what I'm saying? It's just so that so many of our people have been suffering. And then we watch how in our community, it just seems like the spirit of death has overtaken. I'm telling you, if you look at the stats, even in Chicago, so many of the deaths are people of color. So we want to pray for families tonight, and we're praying because this global pandemic has affected so many people, but we still believe in the power of prayer. Amen. So I'm going to ask first my sister Cheryl. Cheryl, this is some of what God has placed in my heart to pray for families and pray for the city of Chicago, pray for the north side, the east side, the west side, to pray for families that are broken, families that are confined in spaces where there is tension and frustration. And so Cheryl, I know that God has dealt with you. Will you share with us what is the area that you're going to be praying in today, and then share a word of prayer in that area?
Well, Pastor, I'd like to share with the families tonight. I remember our mom, as a matter of fact, was working for Jimmy Carter. The Lord revealed to her that he would be the president of the United States. And she was working for the Jimmy Carter campaign. And in actuality, Daddy was working for the Chicago Public School System. And even with both of them working, we still lost our home.
That's right.
We were going through tough times. They were working very hard to take care of the four of us. And I remember them sitting down together one time. I remember when we had to move out of the house, and we really didn't have anywhere to go. And the Lord opened up someone that knew Mom. The Lord touched their heart, and we were able to move like over in the South Shore area, over by where when you found the money.
Yes.
But I want to say to the families that this might be a trying time. Many have lost their jobs. They've lost income. But I want you to know that God hears you, and he will deliver you out of this. You have to also not let aggravation and the tensions of what's going on make you angry and bitter and snapping at each other. You know, you can't, you know, don't let this be a moment of, well, if you was working two jobs, you know how y'all can get sometimes. Yeah. So, you know, I want you to understand that this is a time now where we have to be loving. We need to be kind. We need to be compassionate to each other. The brothers and the sisters, you know, sit them down and tell them, listen, you've got to love your brother, love your sister. I remember we would get together and, you know, we don't talk about daddy much, but daddy would, when we would get ready to pray, he would stand as a silent partner. Yeah. And he would bend his head down and he would pray with us. But there was a strength. You know, Mama was the evangelist. And so she had the boisterous, let's come on, girls. But there was a strength in Daddy that he didn't say much. But we just knew when he stood on his feet, he was going to see about his family. And so I speak to the men of God tonight. Listen, you may not believe like we believe. You may have a different background, a different nationality. But men, I want you all to be encouraged tonight and take on strength to know that God created you in his image. And I want you all to be ever so encouraged. I want you to reach out and, you know, call your aunts. This is a time now where you can see about your cousins and see about the nephews and the nieces. It's just a time to gather in the family. Amen. And so I'll pray for the family tonight. Y'all ready to pray right now?
Yes.
Okay. Well, Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you tonight. And I honor you because you are God, and alone you are God. And tonight I hold up every family member. I hold up the men that are the heads of their households, the men of God, the men that need to see and to prepare and to help their families. Lord, look on the mothers and look on the children. I ask that you would even Lord, tonight, look on those children that are in foster care. Look on those, Lord, that the DCFS needs to see about. God, tonight, I ask that you would saturate the state of Illinois. Lord, saturate us with care and kindness and mercy, and let us be on one accord. Let us understand that divided we fall, but God, there is strength in unity and in oneness. Lord, look on those family members that are facing sickness tonight and they don't know what to do. Lord, they can't get to the hospitals, but we know that you are a healer. We know that you are a deliverer. God, release the spirit of joy. Release the spirit of compassion and happiness in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you now for moving through these families. Let a fresh anointing, let your anointing fall even right now. Go from house to house in the name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you now for moving on the city in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's praise God for that prayer. Praise the Lord. We're believing that God is touching in the lives of families and he's bringing back unity. Amen. And that God is breaking the assignment of division and strife, but he's bringing back oneness in the name of Jesus. I was just thinking about our nation, thinking about our leaders, thinking about the need for the prayer for wisdom. Many of us have never heard the name Dr. Anthony Fauci until very recently with the Center for Disease Control, but he's been encouraging those officials to wait and to let this curve, you know, they call it a peak where there are so many people that they're expecting to die, and then they're asking people to just honor social distancing and washing their hands and staying inside. But do you all know that states are beginning to open back up? I tell you all, we have to pray, because even the scientists and the infectious disease doctors are telling them to wait because of the possibility of this thing starting all over again. Yes. So let us pray for those that are in authority, yes. Amen, and not let it be driven by fiscal policies, right. And by global financial markets, right. That's driving decisions, but let it be the lives that are being affected by this particular virus. I believe God is going to move on our behalf. Bless the name of the Lord. At this time, we're going to hear from Tanya. Tanya, what is it that you're going to share with us?
Praise the Lord, Pastor. First of all, I have my phone because we're receiving prayer requests from families. We're receiving prayer requests that we would pray that God would cure this virus. We're praying for families, as Sister Cheryl has prayed, praying for children, for teens, for young adults. We're praying for those that have lost loved ones, that have lost their mothers, their fathers, and we want to pray for them. We're especially praying for the family, the Evans family. Pastor Clay Evans passed away in December, I believe it was, and Mother Evans passed away recently. And just a few days ago, we lost Sister Faith Evans, his baby daughter. And there are so many people that have lost loved ones and that are hurting right now. And we want to stand in the gap for them tonight. Also, we want to pray. I've been hearing the scripture from so many people all over the country that declares, if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, the Lord said, then will I hear from heaven. I'll forgive their sins and heal their land. But so many of us, we hear that scripture, but have we humbled ourselves? So we want to humble ourselves, and after humbling ourselves, repent and turn from our wicked ways. So many people say, well, I've humbled myself, I'm praying, but have you turned from your wicked ways? Are you still in fornication and adultery and walking in lies and deception? Are you still walking in fear and doing those things that you know that are against God and against his word? Are you shacking up saying you're quarantined because you're with your friend? Right, Lord Jesus. But you're praying. But the Bible says God does not hear some prayers. He said if you regard iniquity in your heart that he does not hear you when you pray. So we want to pray fervently and pray in the spirit, but we want God to hear our prayers. We want those prayers not to be stopped, but to go directly to our Father in the name of Jesus. So I'm going to pray. We're going to pray a prayer of repentance today. So let's pray right now. Father, in Jesus' name, God, we thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your loving kindness, your tender mercies. Your word says, oh, that there are new mercies every morning, for great is thy faithfulness. Father, we take this opportunity to repent of our sins. God, we ask you to forgive us individually. Forgive us as families. Forgive us as ministries and churches. Forgive us as cities and communities. Forgive us as a nation. Forgive the nations of the world. God, we repent from turning away from you in the name of Jesus. God, forgive us for having idols and putting things before you, Father, in the name of Jesus. God, even the Christian, Father, that put the work of the church before seeking your face. Lord, we ask your forgiveness tonight. Forgive us for everything that we've done, things that we've said outside of your will. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God, wash us over again. Purify our hearts. Purify our souls. We want to pray like David. God, create in us a clean heart and renew within us a right spirit. God, forgive us for not being compassionate and loving and taking care of our neighbor. Your word says, love your neighbor as you love yourself. But God, we've been selfish. Lord, forgive us for selfishness. Forgive us for not loving our neighbor as we ought to love them. In the name of Jesus Christ, God, wash us in the blood. Purify us. Cleanse us from our sins. Take away our iniquities. Blot out our transgressions. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, save that daughter. Save that son. Save that mother and father. God, that one that's addicted to drugs. God, that one that's addicted to whatever struggle that they have. God, we ask that you would forgive them and wash them and give them the strength, God, to turn away from everything not like you. God, we turn away from our wicked ways. You said you hate a proud look. You hate a haughty look. In the name of Jesus, hands that shed innocent blood, him that sowed discord among brethren. God, forgive us tonight. Forgive our sins, Lord. As a people, Lord, forgive us, our black nation, God. Oh, God, that we went and bought purses and bought things and tried to appear to be what we were not instead of paying our bills. God, forgive us in the name of Jesus. Forgive us for walking in pride. For you said pride is an abomination unto you. God, forgive us for having a higher opinion of who we are than we ought to have, knowing that you are God. And besides you, there is none other. That we should humble ourselves before you. God, we bow in reverence to your Holy Spirit. We bow in reverence to who you are. For you're God, and you're able to do exceeding and abundant above what we ask or think. God, in the name of Jesus, every family that's watching, every child that's looking at this telecast, God, as that you have left the anointing of God, go out now and begin destroying every yoke in the mighty name of Jesus. God, you're a healer. You're a strong deliverer. There is nothing too hard for you to do. And we stand on your word and we speak by faith in the name of Jesus. Rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. We rebuke the coronavirus. We rebuke the assignment of Satan. We bind premature death. We bind the death angel in the name of Jesus. Father, you said when I see the blood, I'll pass over you. God, we apply and we appropriate the precious blood of Jesus to everyone watching, over our families, over our churches, over our church families. Oh God, over our city. God, let your blood be applied. The blood that'll never lose its power. The cleansing, the redeeming, the saving blood of Jesus. We have saturated this place with the blood. God, let your blood cover now in the name of Jesus. For it's through the blood of Jesus that we are redeemed out of the hand of the devil. It's through the blood of Jesus our sins are forgiven. It's through the blood that we're justified, that we're made righteous just as if we've never sinned. And it's only because of your blood. Let your blood saturate. Oh, in the mighty name of Jesus, your blood cover. The blood of Jesus. The blood over that woman in the hospital. The blood over that man, that child, that woman. Father, in Jesus' name, we apply the blood to the breathing passages. We apply the blood to the lungs, to the esophagus. We apply the healing blood of Jesus. The blood in their sinuses. The blood in the respiratory system. We cast out now coronavirus. We command it to go in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh, God, you're a healer. You were wounded for our transgressions. You were bruised for our iniquities. And by your stripes, we are healed. We speak healing. We declare healing. We loose the power of the healing power of the Lord Jesus Christ. I declare to you, woman, I declare to you, man, rise and be healed in the name of Jesus. We call you off that respirator. We call you off that respirator and command you to breathe with your own breath. Father, oh my, let the breath of the Lord breathe into the nostrils of your people. In the mighty name of Jesus, you're able to do it. And we trust you. We don't doubt you, Father, but we trust you now in Jesus' mighty name for your glory and for your honor. Jehovah.
Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. If you are in a place right now where you need healing, I just want you to lift your hands. While Sister Tanya was praying for healing, we apply the blood of Jesus. We apply the blood to your areas, even, hallelujah, the immune system. We ask that God will move even in your bone marrow. In the name of Jesus, your red blood cells, your white blood cells, in the thymus, in the areas of the immune system, the complex system that causes, hallelujah, that is a support even in the human body. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we apply the blood now. We apply the blood in the respiratory system, the circulatory system, the skeletal system, the systems of the body. God, even the cardiovascular system, let the power of God begin to flow in your body in the name of Jesus. Somebody lift your hands while you're at home and begin to give God the glory for the healing power. The blood be applied, the red blood, the atoning blood, the blood that never loses its power, the blood that reaches to the highest mountain, the blood that flows to the lowest valley, the blood that gives us strength from day to day. Somebody say the blood of Jesus, the blood, the blood, the blood. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost, and we lose the power of healing. We lose the power of deliverance. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we break the powers of the enemy. We bind the devil that's affecting families now. We bind the strong man. God, we lift up the doctors. We lift up the first responders today. God, we pray for the nurses that are in the hospitals. God, many afraid that they're going to contract this virus. Oh, God, we pray for those on the front line. Look on the janitors. Look on those that work in the grocery store. Oh, God, those that serve humanity, that serve the public. Have your way, Lord. God, cover them in your blood in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you for the power of the Holy Ghost. Hi-ya-ya-ya-ya. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Rock in a weary land. Jesus, our shelter in the time of storm. Jesus, our rose of Sharon. Jesus, our lily of the valley. Oh, Jesus, we call you tonight. We call you for those that are watching by way of YouTube, watching on Facebook, watching, oh God, on WJYS. Somebody's troubled. Somebody's depressed. Somebody's oppressed. But break the chain. Break the yoke. Break the shackle. Break the fetter. In the name of Jesus. bless the name of the Lord. Come on, Assistant Pastor JD.
Glory, oh, yeah, glory to God. We thank God for the prayers that have gone on already. And I just want to say to those of you that are watching tonight that we are applying the blood of Jesus to your mind. The Bible says that in the last days, if it were possible, that Satan would deceive the very elect of God. And we loose upon you tonight the mind of Christ. And I know that the enemy would come to cause your mind to race and cause you to wonder and cause you to fear. But there, you don't have to fear in the Lord. And you can stand on his word. I want to say to those of you, I know that they're lifting bands and they're saying that you can go back out. And I want to be reminded that the golf courses are still closed and the major stores are still closed. But they're opening up the barbershops and they're opening up the beauty shops and they're opening up the nail salons. And we want you to pay attention. They're opening up things that would draw, I would say, many of our African-American people to come out. And you may not use wisdom, but I want to say stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I know that many of you remember when you were children how mama used to say, go to your room and I'll be up there a little later. And she would tell you to go and sit down and think about the things that you've done. And I believe in my spirit that God has given us an opportunity to go to our room, to go into our secret places and close the door and think about the things that we've done against his word and against his will. And I want to let you all know tonight that it ain't over yet. And the Lord spoke to me and said, tell my people that it's not over. And I want you all to know that through the joy of the Lord that is our strength, that we're in this world, but we're not of this world. And we don't have to abide by the same rules and regulations as an earthly place, but we have to obey in the natural, but I mean in the spirit realm, that we have another home. It's in glory. And I'm saying to you all tonight to obey the word of God and to be obedient to the laws of the land. And we're going to trust God. Some of you husbands, as Sister Cheryl, Evangelist Cheryl, has called you into that room on tonight. You need to apologize to your wives, and wives need to apologize to your husband. And some of you need to apologize to your children. Pastors need to apologize to congregations. We have to humble ourselves, and we want God to move and super rule, but God is not going to move in your sins. You have to repent for your sins. We are coming against the stronghold of poverty. And you know, Pastor Kim at the beginning of the year told the church on the rock to go on a spending fast, and she gave us instruction from the Lord to save. And we didn't know what was coming up, but we are so glad that we obeyed the Lord. And I want to say to you today, don't stand like you're saying, get on your mark, get ready, get set, and go to get back to the malls and back to the shopping and back to the fleshly things, but get on your face before God and say, Lord, restore me and save me all over again. And Lord, hear my cry. Some of you have not stopped sinning yet, but the Lord is saying, come to me and to humble yourself tonight in the name of Jesus. I want to encourage you all in the name of the Lord before we go into this next phase of prayer, because I want to pray for your mind tonight. You are not losing your mind. Stop saying I'm going crazy, for the power of life and death is in your tongue. And we say to you, you have a sound mind. Put on the mind of Christ. Begin to read your word and let your word take over. Your ways are not his ways and your thoughts are not his thoughts, but we surrender to the Lord and we're saying, Lord, have your way in us. We're just mortal flesh, but we're your sons and we're your daughters, for you said in your word that you would that none would perish, but that all would be saved. Aren't you glad that we have a way to God by his son Jesus, who died on Calvary for our sins? All you gotta do is repent. And so in this few minutes that I'm going to pray, I'm gonna pray for your mind, and I bind the enemy in your mind, and remember that greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And we say tonight in the name of Jesus, we come against every mental blockage. We take dominion and authority over the minds of God's people. Lord, tonight we ask that you would touch the mind of your people. Give them a mind to be saved. Give them a mind to live right. God, in the name of Jesus, go into the very seat of the mind. Go into the pleasure zone of the mind. Go into the right side of the brain. Go into the left side of the brain. The blood, the blood, the blood, the blood. God, we ask
ask that you would move in the minds of your people. Right now, Father, we come against mind racing, mind binding, mind tormenting spirits. We come against that devil that tell them to give up and give in. God, we loose in the name of Jesus the mind of Christ. We loose in the name of Jesus the word of God. Lord, let your mind, let the mind of your people, let it be restored on tonight. God, in the name of Jesus, bring back to their remembrance that you've done for them. Bring back to their remembrance how you blessed them day after day. God, in the name of Jesus, let them be reminded of the day that you first saved them, the day that you filled them with the Holy Ghost. God, in the name of Jesus, we come against all doubt and unbelief. We pull down every stronghold of fear over the mind. God, in the name of Jesus, we take dominion and authority over the city of Chicago, and we bind the mind racing demon. We bind the evil mind, that spirit that have those plotting and planning. We come against every plot, every plan, every scheme, every trick, every lie of the enemy. We shut it down in the atmosphere. We bind murder. We bind rage. We bind anger on tonight in the name of Jesus. Lord, those that are locked in the house and don't know what to do, we bind the enemy over their mind in the name of Jesus. We come against every argument of spirit. We come against strife and contention. The blood, 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 the blood. We bind the devil in the mayor's office. The blood, the blood, the blood. We take dominion over the enemy. We bind the devil over the governor. God, give him strength on tonight in the name of Jesus. Lord, for your glory, in your name, God, stir up your people. Stir them to pray. Stir them to fast in the name of Jesus. We loose your love, God. You said think on the things that are honest, that are pure, that are lovely, that are just. We loose it in the minds of your people. Oh, God, we loose joy unspeakable. Oh, God, we loose love in their soul. Oh, God, take away the pain. Take away the sorrow in your name, Jesus. Give them hope, hope in the hope of glory in the name of Jesus. We speak life here the Messiah. We speak life over Chicago. We speak life in the suburbs. We speak it on tonight in your name. Let this city be an example of your power, of your strength. Let this city be an example of your testimonies in your name, God, for your glory and for your honor. These things we pray in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah. Let's give God a glory, Ray Sister. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord. Again, we thank those of you that are still watching. We want to give you a moment and tell somebody to tune in. We've got a little more time left, praise God, within this hour. And we want you to tell somebody, listen, turn on WJYS. Praise the Lord. Let's pray together and let's be built up by the word of God. God is a source of our strength. He's a very present help in the day of trouble. Hallelujah. Call unto me. I will answer thee and show you great and mighty things. The Bible says, I know the plan that I have for you. It's plans for good and not for evil. Bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. I want to ask Tanya. Tanya, just share with us what the Lord has been dealing with you about. Amen. Just in these next few moments.
Hallelujah. I want to praise encourage the saints that the enemy has struck them, as Pastor Denise said, in their minds and want them to lose their faith. Amen. We have to continue in our faith, believing, hoping, and trusting in God. So many people are saying, well, where is God now? He's still everywhere present at the same time, but he's calling on you to come to him. He's gotten your attention. Amen. Some things we have to accept because God allows them. And so I want to encourage the body of Christ and those that are listening, those that are viewing. If you don't know Jesus, you can know him. All you got to do is repent of your sins, acknowledge that Jesus is the Son of God. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory. That he lived, that he died, he rose again, and he's coming back for his children. Then believe that on the Lord God and receive him in your heart. Repent of your sins. Ask the Lord Jesus, Lord, save my soul. Come into my life. Come into my heart. And then confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord. Confess that I am saved. The Bible says, confess your faults one to another that ye may be healed, that you may be delivered. delivered. God loves you. He cares for you. I want to encourage you to cast all of your cares upon the Lord because he cares for you. I tell you, Pastor Kim, Ray sisters, we're so happy to have this opportunity. And I just want to remind the saints that you're viewing Pastor Kimberly Ray, the Ray sisters, Jay Denise, Cheryl, and Tanya. We are from Angie Ray Ministries, that great church on the rock that's located at 4013 Lindenwood Drive in Matteson, Illinois. And as soon as we can get back together, we'll be together in fellowship with the saints. But until then, we are the church. You are the church. And I want to encourage you to build yourself up in your most holy faith. I want to tell the believer that you used to have a prayer life. You used to have a fasting life. You used to fast for days at the time. And now to fast to 12 o'clock, 3 o'clock is a struggle. Come on, while you have this time alone, while you have this time away from work, seek the face of the Lord. Get back to your Bible. Study the Word of God. Get reacquainted with the Lord Jesus Christ. Ask him to stir your spirit. Give you a new fervor, a new anointing, a new fire, a new power. Give him, ask the Lord to give you a grace for soul winning, to win the sinner man and the backslider. We've switched members long enough, even in the city of Chicago. If I go to that church, I see our old members. If I go to that church, I see that one's members. We've swapped members long enough, but can we win somebody that don't know who Jesus is, that don't know his name, that don't know his power? Won't you share Jesus Christ with somebody today? If you got to do it by telephone, by the way of social media, well, however you've got to do it, let's share the world. Let's share with the world our Savior, his power, his anointing. I thought about someone who was telling us to pray for those that have lost their jobs, those that are going through financially. And I was thinking, I said, Pastor, you know, when we were growing up, Sister Cheryl mentioned it earlier, how our family was going through. We faced eviction. We faced days of being hungry. We don't look like we've ever been hungry, but we had some hungry days. We went to school because if we didn't go to school, we wouldn't have food for that day. I thank God for the free lunch service. Hallelujah. Amen. So there are things that people are going through and things that we face that God brought us out. He delivered us. He broke the yoke of poverty from off of our lives. But then he gave us wisdom and told us and given us knowledge and understanding and told us to start investing in the stock market. Stop wasting money. Stop buying shoes and clothes and purses and invest your money in the kingdom of God. Sow your seeds. Sow your, pay your tithes. Give in your offering. That's how you're going to be blessed. It's more blessed to give than it is to receive. Our pastor told us at the beginning of the year on New Year's night that the Lord said to her to tell the church on the rock that this would be the year of the servant. And so we were trying to figure out, okay, well, how am I going to serve? Where am I serving? Yes, I serve in the church. Yes, I serve on the praise team. I serve with the ushers or greeters or however you serve in the house of the Lord. But are you serving your neighbor? Are you loving your neighbor like you love yourself? Yes. You have an opportunity to feed the homeless. Right. You have an opportunity to give into the houses of the Lord so that your pastor, that your ministry can continue to bless the people of God, to go out and feed the hungry. So I want to encourage you to forget about yourself and remember your neighbor in the name of Jesus Christ. And we also, Pastor, have a prayer request that we would pray for those that who have lost loved ones that are going through the grieving process. Amen.
Amen. Just before Cheryl comes, we're going to ask Cheryl to intercede for those that are bereaved and the grieved families. And I just want to mention again to every person that is watching, God loves you. And we loose upon you the love of God. Romans chapter 3 says, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. But God is faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. Amen. Romans 6:23 says that the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life. I want you to know today that no matter what you've done, if you ask the Lord, as Sister Tanya was saying earlier, to forgive you, to wash you, to cleanse you, I want to remind you tonight that it was the blood of Jesus that paid the price for our redemption. redemption. He satisfied God and gave us access to the Father through the blood of Jesus. And he loves you tonight. God cares about you. Bless the name of the Lord. We're going to hear from our sister Cheryl at this time.
Pastor Kim, I would just like to say to those that have lost loved ones, and then also to those who have loved ones in the hospital and they can't get to them. There's a mother that comes to mind even now whose son is in CCU, and her cry was, I can't hold him. I can't see about him. And there's so many who are standing outside in the parking lots while their loved ones are in the hospitals. And so I believe that Pastor Nisi has that one down in her belly. So I'm going to ask Pastor Nisi, come on. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
I want to say I thank God for healing my body in this area. Many may have heard my testimony. Many of you have not. But I was born with bronchial asthma, and I died once, and my mother called me back to life through prayer. And there were so many days that I thought it would be my last day. I've had so many days close to death. And then, like I said, the day that I literally died. And I want to encourage you all to know that God is a prayer answering God. And I speak today to every person that's going forth and going through in their physical body, that I know for myself that God is a healer. And he said, by the stripes of his son Jesus, that you're already healed. God has equipped your body with everything that it needs for it to heal itself. So we command your body to obey the word. We command your flesh to line up in the name of Jesus Christ. For healing is the children's bread. And by faith, the size of a grain of a mustard seed, that we can ask what we will and it shall be done. So we send the word today. For the Bible said, sent the word. He sent the word and they were healed. And he sent the word and they were delivered. So we send the word right now to every hospital room represented. We send the word of God, the word of healing, the word of deliverance. Body, line up. We command the body to line up. We command the bronchial tubes to line up. Bronchi and respiratory system and circulatory system and red cells and white cells. We command you to line up in the miraculous name of Jesus. For it is not by power, it's not by might, but it's by my spirit, said the Lord of hosts. God, move in the hospital. Move right now in the emergency room. God, let your glory fill the floors in the name of Jesus, in the ICU unit, in the CC units. God, let the blood, the healing blood begin to saturate the chest and saturate the lungs and cause them to line up now. We say, line up, body, in the name of Jesus. We don't ask you to line up, but by the power that's invested in us by way of the Holy Ghost, we command you to line up in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Be healed right now. Be healed right now. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Rise yourself up. I command you to live in the name of Jesus. And I bind doubt and unbelief. We bind doubt and unbelief. We bind the strong man of fear and the strong man of terror. It ain't what it looked like. Devil, you a liar. You a liar. You a liar. You a liar, Satan. And we lose life. The racists touch and agree with you. And we lose a lot in the name of Jesus. Somebody put a praise on it. Somebody put a praise on it. Somebody put a praise on it. He's able to do it. I'm a living witness.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, Lord. Oh, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless his name.
God specializes in things that seem impossible. And he can do what no other power can do. And because God is the greatest power, we shall never be defeated. Bless the name of the Lord. I heard Jesse Jackson say one time, he said, life gets hard sometimes, but suffering brings about character, and character brings about strength. I believe that in the midst of this trial, in everything, we're going to be like Job. Hallelujah. In the midst of his trials, he fell down and he worshiped. I want to encourage you to worship and praise your way through this process. Yes. Keep the faith, my brothers. Keep the faith, my sisters. It won't be long before
before your change comes. Bless his name. Pastor, praise the Lord. Yes, yes, my beloved.
I just want to pray for the pastors that are serving and those that are being faithful, yes, and those that are doing what the Lord is giving you to do. We lose strength on you tonight in the name of Jesus. And I keep hearing an old song, Ray Sisters, I will trust in the Lord,
yes,
until I die. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to stay on the battlefield,
that's right,
in the name of Jesus. Yes. And we lose strength on every pastor, every leader, every servant that's serving the kingdom, yes, of God. We come against the enemy of your soul, yes, and we bind all discouragement from over you tonight, yes, in the name of Jesus.
Name.
Thank God for your prayer request, and we touch and agree. We, yes, believe it, and it is so,
and it is,
and amen.
So. Amen. Amen. We want to again thank God for all of the pastors, every bishop that's watching, all of the fivefold ministry. We honor the Lord for you all tonight. And I was just thinking about the churches of God in Christ. Of course, we have so many friends and family members that are a part of the church, and they've had so many losses, so many deaths within the church. And we just want to send love and strength to them tonight and let them know that we are standing in the gap, making up the hedge for the church and for churches around the nation that have lost pastors, that have lost their leaders as a result of the coronavirus and the COVID-19. We're still standing in the gap. And I want to thank God, as Sister Cheryl was talking about, how some people are sitting outside of the hospital rooms, outside in the parking lot, because they won't allow them to go in. And many have heart-wrenching devastations that they're feeling. But I also want to go back to those that are having to have funerals, where they're reducing the family down to 10 people. Some families have literally so many brothers and sisters, 8 and 9, some have 4 and 5. Children, grandchildren, and then they have to make the daunting decision to choose, Lord have mercy, who can go to the funeral. Amen. You all, we got to continue to pray. We're praying for bereaved families and asking God to move on their behalf. I want to say a prayer for a young lady that lost her daughter on yesterday, a beautiful woman of God that walked in the room and her child was laying in the bathroom floor, passed out, and she then discovered later on that she had passed away. Praise God. I tell you, we're standing in the gap for mothers, yes, that have lost their children, fathers, yes, that have lost their sons. We are standing in the gap, praying and believing God on your behalf. I want to tell you to look up and live, yes, that God is still able to, hallelujah, deliver. Sister Tanya, do you have any more?
Hallelujah. Let's,
yes,
just pray for that group,
yes,
of people.
Yes.
Father, in Jesus' name, we declare your word that you are the comforter, and we loose the spirit of comfort over every bereaved family. Father, we speak your word, that God, that you would comfort them, that you would cause their hearts to be held in the palm of your hand. Lord, touch that mother, touch that man, that woman, that boy, that girl that's grieving. Touch our sister that lost her daughter, that woman that lost her mother. God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we loose the spirit of comfort. God, you see and you know. God, bottle the tears. God, give them strength. Give them courage. Give them wisdom. We bind division in families. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, God calls them to stand as a unit of one. God, strengthen in your sons and daughters. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, be their defense, Father. Be their strength tonight. In Jesus' mighty name. God, only you can heal during this time and season. Lord, we don't know how they feel altogether, but God, you know, for you know all things. And we ask today that you would touch, heal, and deliver and set free according to your word, and in the mighty and matchless name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Again, we thank God for this time. We want to take a moment and thank God again for Pastor Meeks and First Lady Jamel Meeks as well. We send our love to her, and we thank God for this opportunity to stand in the gap and to pray. And I want to thank God for my husband, Elder Victor Gavin, amen, who is a first responder. I call him a brave warrior because they go out into the trenches and they do the work that is necessary to protect, to
sheriffs and police,
yes,
officers,
to serve and protect.
Prisoners.
Yes, he serves and protects. And we want to thank God for all of the Chicago police, all of the Cook County sheriffs. We want to thank God for all that serve. Amen. Those that are nurses, again, we just have really have been praying for the nurses and the doctors. We just want to say thank you. All of us would like,
Pastor,
to say thank you for your service.
Pastor, can I speak a word to the nurses?
Yes,
right,
please, please,
all
Tanya.
All of the Christian, sanctified, Holy Ghost-filled, fire-baptized nurses and doctors, I loose the power of God upon you, that when you serve and touch one of those people that are going, that's in the hospital, that's in their bed, that you're serving by their bedside, that you have to be that one that comfort them, I speak the power of God rise up in you,
yes,
in the name of Jesus, and that the Holy Ghost will touch and use your hands to lay hands on the sick and command them to recover in the name of Jesus. I want every nurse to give God a praise for a fresh anointing and fresh fire to be a healer in the hospital room in Jesus' name. Glory.
Glory to God, because one of you can chase 1,000.
Yeah.
Two of you can put 10,000 to flight. Yeah. Where two or three of you are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst. Do you all still believe in the power of agreement?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I touch and agree right now. I want to ask every person viewing to do something real quick in the final moments of this telecast. I want you to say your whole name out loud. And I want you to declare over your life that even in the midst of this global pandemic, in the midst of this state of emergency, I want you to speak out of your mouth that I am blessed. And the blessings of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob are about to overtake me. This will be my year of jubilee. God's going to give me land. God's going to restore. Hallelujah. God is going to give mercy. God is going to do what he promised that he would do. Guess what else he said in the book of Leviticus? He said debt cancellation. I believe that in the midst of this crisis that God can touch somebody that holds your mortgage to release it. Come on, somebody, and give you a free month. Hallelujah. I believe God to touch the heart of the person that is your landlord and tell you you don't have to pay for April. Make sure you talk to him though. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But I know God is able. He can do all things. Amen. But fail. Let's give God a praise, Ray sisters. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord in our final moments. Thank you again for allowing this time. We love you all with the love of Jesus. Thank praise Jesus. God. And we want to
still on social media.
Yes, hi to Facebook. We love you, family. Please, please reach out to us. Let us know that you're watching.
You can reach Pastor Kim at kray@angierayministries.com. Send your prayer request to that email address, kray@angierayministries.com.
And all of the Ray sisters, send our love to all of our Facebook, YouTube family. You all stay in touch with us, reach out to us, and let us know that you're doing okay.
Because God is the greatest power.
Yes. Come on, Tanya.
We will never. Come on, Christian. Hallelujah. And because God is the greatest power,
sing it, Tanya.
We shall never, never be defeated. Cheryl, tell me to get up. Because God is the greatest power. We shall never, never be defeated. Oh, because God, he's the greatest power. We shall never, never be
never be defeated.
The devil is a lie.
Come on, Tanya.
And God is exalted.
Yes.
We'll never be defeated.
Never be defeated. Yes.
Satan is a liar. And God is exalted.
We'll never be defeated.
We defeated the coronavirus.
Yeah, we made it.
Hallelujah. You made it.
Yes.
We made it. Be encouraged. We love you with the love of Jesus.
Yes.
God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Because God is the greatest power.
Yes.
We shall never be defeated.
Praise the Lord. Again, we love you all with the love of Jesus. Facebook, God bless you. Thank you so much for allowing us this time. We bless you all in the precious, matchless name of Jesus Christ. Be encouraged in the Lord.